Rabbi Marc Kline in Monmouth Reformed Temple. This week we finish the Torah cycle and start the Torah cycle. We read Vezot HaBracha, the last portion in the Torah, and also the first words of Bereshit. So we're turning the cycle. The year has changed. Rosh Hashanah is behind us. We celebrated the birthday of the world. And looking forward to we're not sure what. Not one of us could have imagined this time last year what this year would have brought. And so every year when we turn the cycle of reading Torah over, we look expectantly and hopefully for new adventures. And well, this year has been an adventure. And so we're 1 year older than we were, and we have another year of experience, and we get to see the Torah with some brand new eyes. New lenses. The school's going to be different, or is different. Our dining services are very different. Our social lives have taken on a whole virtual life, literally. And so, you know, the one thing that is constant in our life is Torah. And the words of it haven't changed in thousands of years, but we get to keep bringing new eyes to it every year, and we reread the words. And so this year it's going to say things that are different than it did last year, and we're blessed for that. But I'll tell you, the story ends as Moses walks off with God. You know, the old cowboy scene, walks off into the sunset with God, and God will eventually bury him as the people will cross into the land, the promised land. And then we'll turn the story right back to the beginning, and Adam and Eve will walk with God. And so even as we end the story of one hero's life, we begin the story of the next set of heroes. And that cycle will continue all the way through the year and next year and the year after. So what do we take away from this idea of the circular nature of relationships and these stories that keep playing out? Well, nothing new under the sun. It's from Ecclesiastes. And we know that our relationships are going to continue to blossom and ebb and flow. And there are going to be times that we're really going to appreciate each other, and there are times that we're going to want to completely disassociate from each other. And that's an ever-going cycle. But what we learn from Torah is that it's all good and it all starts over again. And we have the opportunity to renew if we make that happen, if we take the chance on hope and on faith. It takes a lot of faith to make sure that we grow and continue to grow. But what it really takes faith to do is to do it together. And so our Torah teaches us that you can't do this by yourself. And so there are relationships that we may have severed or that we may not have participated in for a while, but everybody matters. And if we're serious about starting over with Adam and Eve and taking it forward, then I think we need to make those phone calls. We need to make those visits and start those relationships over again. Sometimes we'll be able to pick up right where we left off. Sometimes we'll have to find a way to start over again. But it's a new year. And if we only approach this new year carrying forward our old baggage, then that may be the greatest of blasphemies. So let's make it a year of opportunity to renew and to renew together. So I wish you a Shabbat Shalom. And a happy holiday, as Simchat Torah is this weekend. And please know that so much is being done to support our community. Your help could increase our opportunity to share value and to heal the world. So be in touch with us, Monmouth Reformed Temple.